Hi, my name is Thomas Schoborg. I'm the chef at the Cajun Experience here in Adams Morgan. It's a beautiful Wednesday night, and the best part about my job is that I get to do a crawfish boil every week. Tonight's a special night. We're doing one for a party. I want to show you guys how we do a traditional Louisiana-style crawfish boil. The first step is having a giant pot of water. In this case, we're going to season the water first, then we're going to wash the crawfish, and we're going to add the traditional accompaniments, boil everything together. So to start, the most important thing is plenty of butter. In this case, we're adding 2 pounds to about 40 quarts of boiling water. While the butter is important, it helps the seasonings to stick to the crawfish when they come out of the water. 2 pounds of butter. After that, crawfish lovers know that the crawfish have to be spicier. The spicier, the better. In this case, we're going to add an entire container of ground cayenne pepper for plenty of heat. Ideally, the water is almost red with pepper by the time it's ready. Make sure you don't get this in your nose. Next up is your favorite brand of a Louisiana crawfish boil seasoning. Zatarain's is great. Tony Cajure's is great. In this case, we're using Louisiana brand. We're going to add 2 whole bags of this. This is basically a blend of paprika, onion powder, garlic powder, and other spices to help to season the crawfish. Seasoning salt. Next up, we're going to add just a little more salt. When you cook crawfish, it's almost like cooking shrimp. The water should be as salty as seawater. In this case, I'm going to put about 2 cups of salt. Kosher salt. Now we're putting crawfish boil bags. These are full of coriander seeds, mustard seeds, and chili flakes. Add a lot more dimension, a lot more depth to the flavor of the crawfish. I'm gonna put 4 of these bags in. All right, now if you could come with me, we're gonna open the crawfish up. The most important thing is they're still fresh and alive. Crawfish season goes from December till about July, so we're right at the tail end of crawfish season, which is perfect because the crawfish are always larger at the end of the season. This is actually the last week we can do it. After this, the season's closed until next year. Here they are, and as you can see, they're still alive and kicking. Flown in fresh from Louisiana just this morning. Now tonight we're doing 150 pounds. I'm gonna start with about 20 pounds just to get the water nice and seasoned. Now all we need to do is just give them a nice, quick little rinse, and they're ready for the pot. We're going to rinse them off and then strain them out through the colander. You can see that some of these guys are nice and big. Look at this one. This is a good sized crawfish. You can see as soon as the water hits the crawfish, they really start coming back to life. No crawfish boil would be complete without corn, potatoes, and andouille sausage. So we're going to add some fresh corn on the cob. The thing about the crawfish boil is all the food is cooked in one pot. We've got some nicely seasoned Cajun potatoes, red bliss. Last but not least, freshly smoked pork andouille sausage. Nice big chunks. And in they go. So we'll give everything one nice big stir. Now we're going to add the lid and wait for it to come back to a boil. As soon as it comes back to a boil, they're ready to go. We wait for about 10 minutes. Okay, it looks like they're just about done. If you've ever cooked lobster before, you'll know the color you're looking for. Nice, bright red shells. And are perfectly cooked like this. The meat separates very easily from the shell, and it's nice and plump and juicy. Here we go. Now the potatoes, the corn, everything cooks at the exact same time, and it finishes at the exact same time. Looks like that's enough for meat. Let's start with the rest of them now.